we can understand how the expression hocus pocus came from in Wilt Durant's book called The Reformation. Now I'll show a picture of this book, and this is where the expression hocus pocus came from. No, my friends, when Jesus spoke to the Pharisees and said, "Except you eat of my body and drink of my blood, you're not going to go to heaven," they said, "What, do we have to eat your body?" Jesus said, "The spiritual things are for the spiritual man, the earthly things are for the earthly man. What I speak unto you is spiritual." It was to eat of the fact that he died at Calvary's cross as a payment for sin, and to partake in that cup. And that is to receive the free gift that he died for us. The Catholic Encyclopedia, volume 14, page 586, confirms the fact that the whole Christ, flesh, body, blood and soul, divinity and humanity, is really present in the body and blood of Christ found in the bread. Now examine this ministry.
There are some Christians who are awake to what's going on, but there are many Christians today who believe everything is just fine. Everybody loves everybody else. The Christians, Mormons, Jews, Jehovah's Witnesses, Muslims are all serving the same God, but in different ways. If I asked, "Can you partake of the Lord's Supper with Catholics?" they'd say, "Why not?" Let's find out if there is a difference between the Lord's Supper and the Mass. Before I go on, let me explain that the bread or wafer used in the Mass is called the host. Now, when the host has been consecrated and offered as a sacrifice in the Mass, it then becomes the Eucharist. I'm going to try to put into everyday language what is one of the great motivating forces behind the Roman Catholic institution. It is the Eucharist. The Roman Catholic institution in their canon laws state, quote, "If anyone shall deny that the body, blood, together with the soul and divinity of our Lord Jesus Christ, and therefore entire Christ, are truly, really, and substantially contained in the sacrament of the most holy Eucharist, and shall say that he is only in it as a sign or in a figure, let him be accursed." Accursed means to be damned under a curse. Now, to sum this up, the Roman Catholic institution teaches that you must believe that the bread or host consecrated in the Mass actually becomes Jesus Christ, and it is to be worshipped as God Almighty.
Now, my friends, I'm sure there's some faithful Catholics that didn't know about transubstantiation. Just ask your local priest. Now, in Catholic belief, this sacrifice is a renewal of the sacrifice of the cross. Christ commanded that his bloody sacrifice on the cross should daily be renewed by an unbloody sacrifice of the Mass, they say. Now, because the elements are changed into Christ, he is present in our churches, they add, and not only in a spiritual manner, but in a real manner. He is a victim of sacrifice. Now, this is found in the Catholic Encyclopedia, volume 10, page 6. Now, the very idea of Christ, flesh and blood, body, soul and divinity, being offered repeatedly as a renewal of sacrifice stands in sharp contrast to what he said on the cross. It is finished. The Bible says that he offered himself once and for all for sin, one sacrifice for sin forever, in Hebrews 10:10-14. Now, this is what Catholics believe, but the New Testament says that if Christ needs to be offered over and over again, then they crucify to themselves the Son of God afresh and put him to open shame in Hebrews 6:6. What you see here is a picture of the monstrance. After the bread has been changed into Christ by the priest, it is placed in this monstrance, and at the center, it looks like a sunburst design. Before the monstrance, Catholics will bow down and worship the little wafer as God. Now, I know it sounds foolish, but yet this is what it states, and this is what is a doctrine of the Church. The Catholic Encyclopedia says, in the absence of scriptural proof, the Church finds warrant for the divine worship of the Blessed Sacrament in the most ancient and constant tradition. Now, this reasoning brings to mind the words of Jesus when he said, "Making the Word of God without any effect through the traditions of your father," in Mark 7:13. Now, in the New Testament Church, it is evident that Christians partook of both the bread and the wine. Now, this is an emblem of Christ's death, his broken body for us. But after all these centuries, the Romish Church began to hold back the cup from the people, serving only the bread. Now, one argument said that one might spill the blood of Christ, but it was also possible for the early disciples to do the same. Christ didn't withhold it from them. Now, Jesus, in explaining to the Pharisees that he that eateth and drinketh of my body and blood shall inherit the kingdom of God, was speaking about the free gift at Calvary. Yet the Pharisees, in their carnal minds, said, "What? Do we have to eat of your body and drink your flesh?" Jesus said, "That which is spiritual belongs to spiritual things, and that which is earthly is earthly." Jesus was talking about a symbol of the broken bread, his broken body, and the blood shed as the new covenant or the new bargain made between man and God via Calvary. Now, Holy Mother Church explains that communion, under one kind as it is called, was just as valid as taking both. Now, did the idea of transubstantiation begin with Christ? Well, the historian Durant tells us that the oldest ceremonies of pagan primitive religions was to change vegetation into their gods and then eat them. Now, Hastings' Encyclopedia of Religion and Ethics has an article devoted on eating the god. The Catholic Encyclopedia, Volume 10, page 104, has this to say: Mithraism had a Eucharist, but the idea of a sacred banquet is as old as the human race and existed at all ages amongst all people. Now, the word cannibal, we know that there were priests of Baal. Baal has provided the basis of our modern word cannibal, eating of the gods. During Mass, members of the Romish Church in good standards may come and kneel before the priest who says, "This is the body of Christ." Now, when Jesus instituted the memorial supper, he simply took bread and broke it. Bread doesn't break into round pieces. Breaking of the bread represents his broken body for us through a cruel beating. But this symbolism is not carried out by a serving of round discs wafer completely whole. If the use of the round wafer is without scriptural basis, it is possibly linked to pagan religions. Now examine this hieroglyphic, where they worship the sun, and the round wafer is nothing but a symbol of the sun. Sun worship. This is found in Egyptian mythology. Now we know that round cakes were used in ancient Egypt. The thin round cakes occur all over altars, in mystery religions as Mithraism. Now, the round cakes play a prominent role in unleavened bread, symbolizing solar disks. Now, the use of sun images above the altar in sun worship was not limited to Egypt. Even as far away as Peru, the images were known and worshipped. Now, if there is any doubt that the shape of the host was influenced by sun worship, one may simply compare the sun images before the heathens as they bowed before the monstrance of sun images before their altars. Examine the monstrance in the shape of the sun with the host, meaning sacrifice, right in its center. Now, the upcoming photograph shows the altar of St. Peter's Square, where a huge canopy 95 feet high, which is supported by four columns, is twisted and slightly covered with branches. At the top of the column on high, above the most important altar in Catholicism, are sun images like those which were used in pagan religions. Now, the walls, as you see here, have elaborate golden sunburst images, which, from the entrance of the church, also appear above the altar. Now, a large sun image also appears above the altar of the Church of Gesù Rome, where hundreds of others also appear. Now, in 2 Chronicles 34 and 4, it says they broke down these altars by Baal and also the images that were high above them, above the altar. Here we see a sunburst dial in a fountain near Rome. Now, sometimes the circular sun images were found in stained glass windows above the altar, as it is very common in some churches. Now, what we see here is the Roman Catholic monstrance, and as you see, it isn't